guys, and welcome to Mark Shrimp Tanks. I thought today we'd talk about an issue I see a lot of you guys having problems with, and that is how to make baby shrimp live longer. And basically what you want to do with this, guys, is you want to create a biofilm wall in your tanks. So it's kind of can be a little bit hard to show you, but you might be able to pick out a biofilm layer if you look at the side of the tanks here. You see it, there's like a brown layer here on the glass. This is biofilm. It's actually in all the tanks, but it can be very, very hard to see. This tank is green, so I'm not going to see it so well. Right, so this is what this is. I think you might be able to see if I come over this angle. If you look at this glass here on the inside, let's see, will it show? You can see some of it near the bottom. This is biofilm. On this side here, where the glass looks dirty, on the inside, this is actually biofilm as well, right? Now, basically what biofilm is a layer. Think of it like a matrix, right? You have interlocking layers that's filled with different types of bacteria and different kinds of algae, right? And so when you have baby shrimp, when they come along, they will pick through these layers and take food from it, right? So biofilm is very, very important in a shrimp tank. Not just for the babies, for the adults as well, but this is what we're going to concentrate on today. Is biofilm, how to build a biofilm layer in your shrimp tanks to increase the survivability of your shrimp. Okay, so one of my favorite products to do this with is over here, Nutridust. I have other ones, but the one I use the most is this Nutridust one here, and this is more or less a high protein powder that has different things like brewer's yeast, montmorillonite, one of my favorite minerals to use in a shrimp tank, and moringa. Now moringa is also very, very good for shrimp. It has a lot of vitamins, minerals, etc. So this is very, very good for baby shrimp. It's very good for building a biofilm layer. I think possibly you saw this before when I did, I think I showed you my daily feeding routine before with this, maybe in the multi-pack ones, I think. And you saw how much biofilm grew in here. So that is what this video is about today. We're going to give the shrimp some. Now, one thing as well, guys, right, is I never go by the doses on packages, because I think sometimes they're a little bit too much. Okay, but interestingly enough, the one that come with this is small, right? So the maker, Dennis is one of my friends. This is not an advert for him, by the way. This is an advert for how to make your biofilm, right? Interestingly enough, the spoons that he's provided are the correct size, right? But the only problem with Dennis's ones is the spoons are small, right, and this is quite a narrow container, and it's very, very hard for me to get the spoon in and out like this without dropping it all the time. Right, so what I tend to do is I put it into a little tub like this. This is so you can see what the powder is like as well. Right, and then I get my little spoon like this. This is one that I use all the time. You can tell I use it all the time because it's a little bit dirty. Right, and I like to kind of do level teaspoons in large tanks and like quarter to half in the smaller tanks. Right? So all I do is I add it in. I used to mix it in with water and stuff, but let's see. Can you see that going in? And this normally sends my shrimp into like a frenzy. There are no lures in this food. There's nothing in this that will... God, this is so much harder than I thought it was going to be to get a little bit of food out. There's no lures in this to make the shrimp come to the food. A lot of products do have that in it. I know for sure a lot of Dennis's stuff doesn't. So we're just going to add a little bit into each tank, and you can see it. See how fine the particles are? A very, very fine powder. In the bigger tanks, as I said, I put a whole scoop in. And I tend to do this every second day. I don't do this every single day. Give this a little quarter. Give this one a little bit of a quarter of a spoon as well. This big one here will get a full spoon. Like so. You see how fine the powder is? It's like a dust. And the reason we use this as well, guys, is because Shrimp, when they're small, in my opinion, they are very, very stationary. Okay? But at least for the first week anyway, they are super stationary. So you want to put a fine layer of biofilm across most of the surfaces in the tank. And this will provide food for baby shrimp wherever they are in the tank. Hello! Shrimp tanks are looking awesome. How's the tangerine tigers doing in here? I can see a lot of them are starting to get buried up. So this is a sign that there are females here as well. And this one you can see, it's got the little white patch in the back of its head. This one's got a little bit of a white patch, but it's also starting to form a saddle. Let's see, where's the babies? Where's the babies? But you can see in here the powder floats everywhere. I'm going to quickly go into macro mode just so you can see some of the baby blue steels in this tank, okay? Okay, so now we're into macro mode and we're looking at some of the chola wood here. I've actually noticed that the baby shrimp really like chola wood. I noticed in some of my other tanks where I have it as well that the chola wood itself tends to get quite a bit of algae on it. I don't know why it's not focusing. Go on, focus. Anyway, on this one, let's see if we can see any baby shrimp. Oh, the blue steel. Oh, these ones gorgeous. I'm going to zoom in. Aren't they amazing? Now, I might go in and out of focus a little bit here. Look at this little fella, and he's hunting for biofilm. How about his little buddy over here? I think in this tank there are a couple of different batches in here of baby shrimp, because they are different sizes. This is one of my crossbreeding tanks. In the next batch there should be a Tybee mixed with blue steels, a zebra type Tybee mixed with blue steels, so this tank is going to be really, really awesome in a little while. It's already awesome, but it's going to be even more awesome. Aren't they cool? I don't know why it's not focusing here. It's in macro mode, focus you effer. There you go, you must have the camera too close in macro mode. Anyway, so guys, that is how you build your biofilm in your shrimplet tanks. There are other foods you can use, but this is the one I recommend, because this is the one I use all the time of all the products that I have, okay? Thank you for watching, guys, and I'll catch you all in the next one. Happy shrimp keeping.